Yo, what's going on, family? I want to hop in here real quick and talk to you all just real quick. So I got this word yesterday, and God was just ministering to my spirit. You know, the Bible says that a laborer is first partakers of the fruit, right? So he was ministering to me, and the only thing that he said to me is break the cycle. Break the cycle. And so I got an immediate revelation. Break the cycle. What does break the cycle actually mean? Break the cycle means do something different. If you know the enemy is going to come at you in one way, won't you switch it up on him? Turn the other way. Do something that you know he's not expecting you to do. Change up the way that you, it might be the way that you eat. It might be the way that you do certain things. It might be the way that you think. Change it up. Switch it up. Do something different. Read a book today. Read another chapter, another verse. You might read two chapters. Read three today. Do something different. Switch it up on him. And so one of the things that I realized about myself today is when I got out of the gym, my mind, I really started to amp up and intensify the way that I think. And I just want to do something uncomfortable. You know, I want to put myself in a position where I can be uncomfortable. And the reason why is because the more uncomfortable positions that you are in, believe it or not, the most uncomfortable thing that you do will bring you the most benefits. Do you understand that your comfort zone does not bring you much benefit at all? Because it does not produce growth or change. So you got to put yourself sometimes in positions of being uncomfortable. It's okay to be uncomfortable because change is uncomfortable. And so one of the things I really want you to realize today is that the enemy cannot premeditate an attack on your life if he does not know what to expect from you. You better hear what I'm trying to tell you today, that Jesus was great. He was great at leaving the devil with unexpected results and things that he did in his life. Jesus was what we call eccentric. And eccentric, the definition of eccentric means to do something outside of the nature of the culture. And so Jesus did not live by culture. So it was hard for the enemy to try to get his hands on him because he did not do what culture told him to do. But what's going on today is the enemy got his hands on you right now because you're following the same pattern of culture. So he's used to that. That's his familiarity. That's his place. That's his playground. You got to get off the devil playground and create your own. Do you understand what I'm telling you right now? You have to get off the devil's playground and create your own. And this is what we call breaking the cycle. Won't you start today? Start today. Do it today. Don't wait till tomorrow. You might not live until tomorrow. Do it today. Do it today. We pray to God that we live until tomorrow. But we can't expect to live to tomorrow because we don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. He says, start today. Today. Get up and go today. Don't wait.